The Black-White Achievement Gap is an aggregate measure of progress that we're making or lack of progress in racial disparities in this country. It's a pretty simple measure. It's the average achievement of Black students minus the average achievement of white students. What we know from the National Assessment of Education Progress's Mathematics Grade 8 assessment is that the achievement gap in 2015 was virtually unchanged from the achievement gap in 1990. In 1990, the achievement gap was 33 points. It grew to about 40 points in 2000. And then in recent years, it's come back down. In 2015, the achievement gap was 32 points. While there's been a lot of research on the Black-White achievement gap, there's been relatively little research about the role of school composition in the Black-White achievement gap. And because there are current concerns about the growing resegregation of schools, it's become more important to understand the role of school composition. The approach that AIR took was to look specifically at schools where Black students were acutely isolated. So using the 2011 Mathematics Grade 8 assessment and about 100,000 records of student achievement, we took a look at the relationship between the achievement gap and school composition. So what we did was we looked at schools and we defined a term which we call in the report the density of Black students in a school, which is measured by the percentage of students in the school who are Black. And we categorize schools into high density and low density. And so for high density, those are schools that where 60% or more of the student body is Black, and low density is where 20% of less of the students in the school are Black. In our first look at the data, what we did was we compared the achievement of students in high-density schools to students in low-density schools. And what we found is that the achievement gap in high-density schools is the same as the achievement gap in low-density schools. But we also found that the achievement of Black students and white students were lower than their in the high-density schools than their counterparts in the low-density schools. So as a next step, we wanted to take a look, well, do these patterns hold when we take into account differences between the high-density schools and the low-density schools? In particular, we reconducted our analysis accounting for differences between the students in terms of their socioeconomic status and their demographics, differences in the teachers in terms of their credentials and teaching methods, and differences in the school in terms of the overall socio-demographic characteristics of the schools. In the high-density schools, the achievement gap was wider than in the low-density schools when we accounted for the student, teacher, and school characteristics. In particular, we found that among white students, achievement was relatively the same, but achievement for Black students was lower in these high-density schools. And then, to dig even deeper into these results, we disaggregated our results by males and females. And here's where we found our most striking result. That we found that this pattern held for males, but not for females. We found that for white males, achievement was relatively the same, but for Black males, achievement was lower. When I look at this research, I look, why do we care about the achievement gap, and why do we care about segregation? We care about the achievement gap, and we care about segregation because of a long history of racism in this country. We are concerned about the outcomes of all students, and the achievement gap is an important indicator of racial disparities, an important indicator of the need to seek ways to improve the life chances of Black students, in particular Black males.